Hi, my name is Emily Turla, and I'm the laboratory coordinator for the FAU Marine Science Lab. I've been here since February of 2018, and today I'm going to walk you guys around, and you're going to get to see some of our research animals and some of our different research sites in the lab. So this is the area where we raise leatherback sea turtles, which is one of the three species that we bring into the lab. And we're actually the only lab in the world that raises leatherback sea turtles because they're so challenging to keep in captivity. This is because they need specific water quality parameters. They eat a gelatinous diet like jellyfish, which is really hard to mimic in the lab. They're susceptible to disease, and they don't understand barriers. So they're out in the open ocean, swimming around, not encountering any barriers. So when you put them in a tank, it's really hard to keep them from hitting the sides of it. So leatherbacks require really specific water quality parameters because they're out in the open ocean. They need water that mimics clean open ocean water. So we put our water through a series of filtration systems to make sure that it's clean, doesn't have any microbes or particles in it, and that it's at a specific temperature. And behind me is the protein skimmer, which is just one part of that water filtration system. We bring three different species of sea turtle into the lab, and back here is where we have two of the species, the loggerhead and the grain. Some of our research that deals with sea turtles is looking at how the climate is affecting their sex ratios, their development, and their behavior. So when we first bring turtles in, we observe them for a period of time to make sure that they're eating and behaving normally and that they're healthy. And then once we determine that they're healthy, we can merge them in with our study colony and start collecting data on them. This big tank is used for projects that house larger sharks or that need more room for whatever research is being conducted. And we can also house turtles in this tank. In addition, it's been used to film a movie because it has a special screen for underwater filming. This area of the lab is set up for ocean acidification research and how it affects plant ecology. So they're testing how different algae and plants are responding to different ocean conditions as a result of climate change. So this is our kitchen area where we prepare the food for the different research animals that we bring into the lab. So that's fish for the sharks and the rays, or that's the homemade food for the turtles, the loggerheads, the greens, and the leatherbacks. And we make sure to keep everything separate between species, especially for the leatherbacks, because we don't want any contamination since they're so sensitive. This is our multi-purpose procedure room where we do things like weighing and measuring some of our turtles, satellite tagging our turtles, and the medical imaging for the sex ratio study. So here we are back in the office where we house a lot of our supplies, and we have all of our data books with all the data recorded from everything out in the lab area that I just showed you. And this is also where we work on data on the computers and start to analyze it and see what we're finding with the data that we're collecting. So I've shown you the inner workings of what we do at the Marine Lab, and here we're in the visitors gallery where the public can come and see science in action. And in the visitors gallery, we have some signage that has text explaining some of the research projects that we've done or have going on. And it also gives the public the opportunity to speak to the students and the researchers who are down on the floor doing the research. And so you're probably wondering, why do we do all of this research, or what is the point of the FAU Marine Lab? And our mission is to better understand species and how they're interacting with and being affected by their environment. We are trying to make better researchers out of our students that come and participate in the lab, and we're trying to communicate science to the